Hello, I'm Bill Voss. I'm a physician assistant with the North Carolina Academy of Physician Assistants. I'd like to introduce you to the Eugene Stead Center for Physician Assistants. This is our State Academy office and focal point and number of historical objects in here back from the early days of physician assistants, including Dr. Stead's office from his home that he proceeded to give to us after he died, along with several things in the garden, some of his plants, and some of his statuary out of his garden. It's a really neat place, and we're very proud of it.
Bill, tell me a little bit about the Physician Assistant Program. Where did it start?
Physician Assistant Program was started by Dr. Stead in 1965, looking to help erase the shortage of medical providers and trying to tap into the supply of ex-medical corpsmen who were coming back from the Vietnam War with vast experience, but who were then going into other fields and not following up in medicine. And it provided, in the early days, an avenue for those people to get back into and continue their medical career.
Now, Bill, you actually knew Dr. Stead?
Met him several times, spent a couple days with him on different occasions. When we first started talking about building this building and putting his name on it, we spent a day with him and got his permission to do this. And then we went back and spent another day with him, just basically picking his brain, which an amazing fellow. He used to come down to our winter meetings in Research Triangle and spend a day or two for many years before he finally passed on. But up until that point, he was a frequent visitor. This wall, we have several montage of our founding fathers from back in the early day. Of course, Dr. Stead started the first program here at Duke University back in 1965. And then Dr. Richard Smith, out of the University of Washington, started the MedX program. Dr. Silver, Dr. Kirkland, and Dr. Myers, also from the early days of the founding fathers of the profession. This is Dr. Stead's office from his home up on Kerr Lake in northern North Carolina. We went up and took pictures of the entire layout of his office so that we could replicate it here. So basically, it's a lot bigger room than he had in his office, but the pictures are arranged identically. The bookcase of the books are the same as they were in his office. The coat rack with his white coat and stethoscope and blood pressure cuff on it. The things that were on his desk, including his glasses that were laying on the paper, we recreated as closely as we possibly could to be exactly the same as it was in his office and in his home. Lots of pictures. He was a big historical buff. He enjoyed keeping mementos around from his past classes. Family, he was really close to his family. Had three children, two of which were physicians. A very remarkable person.
Now, Bill, I asked you if he had any trials or tribulations that you knew of when forming the Physician Assistant Program.
I'm not aware of any. That was several years before I came in the picture, obviously, but I've never heard stories about that being a big problem. And I wouldn't think he would have had much problem because he was so high up on the food chain at Duke University at the time. I had a hard time seeing anybody questioning him about anything.
Hey, Bill, tell me a little bit more about the military involvement in for the physician assistant development.
Well, the original four PAs were all ex-military, and it just, with the people coming back from Vietnam at that time in the mid-60s, vast experience, I mean, incredible experience in all fields, but they didn't have really an avenue to keep in the medical field unless they went into nursing or became an EMS or medic, something along those lines. And this was a way of utilizing their great training and experience and keeping them in a medical field and helping to ease the physician shortage that was going on at that time and continues to this day. And this is some of the plaques and the God Loves a Grunt picture that we have here, just commemorating the military start of the PA profession. This is a combat medic statue that we were fortunate enough to work with the University of Utah and Don Kraus, Reg Carter. There's a number of people involved with this to get this on this facility as a reminder that our basis comes back to the combat medic. Don Peterson was a big pusher of this and really, really helped us get this going. It really was the impetus behind it.
Bill, I think that's a really awesome tribute to the military forefounders that came into this program. I really think this is an awesome tribute to our profession and where we came from.
This wall, we just have several, again, a montage of information going back on again to the early days of the profession, the early organizations, here going back to the origin of the American Academy of Physician Assistants, actually was chartered in North Carolina in 1969. Some of the early people involved there, there's Bill Stanhope, Denver, Dr. Robert Howard, David Glazer, all these men back from the late 60s, early 70s. And there's Dr. Fisher from the 80s. Just a wealth of historical information out here. We would welcome anyone who would like to come and visit. We'd be happy to show them around and show them a whole lot more than what we can do on this little video.